Guys, welcome back to the Acro class online. Today we're learning a fun Acro balance. It's a counterbalance in a back bird position, but it's a side back bird position. It's really unique looking, and yet not that hard to do if you can get down the techniques correctly. Okay, but first, of course, we're going to show you a possible fall to look out for. So we'll get into position here. We first get into it from folded leaf. I'm gonna go onto one leg. We'll call this koala. She looks like a little koala bear. And as she kicks over, go ahead and kick over, Magda. If she kicks over this way, and my, if I lose my balance and come down this way, she's gonna hit her head. So we wanna be really careful to not drop her down this way. And we'll show you how to keep her safe, okay? Did I kill you, Magda?
No.
Okay. Okay. Okay, so now let's show you little tips to prevent that from happening and doing it correctly. We're first gonna get into folded leaf, bring the feet out. She's gonna take her weight off this leg, bring it all the way over on one foot here. So as she brings it over, I'm gonna slip my foot down a bit towards in between both her legs. And she's deep piking so that she can hang out on that one leg, okay? Deep piking there. Very important to find the placement here. So midline, of course, she's safe here. She's not too bad because she's low towards the ground. This foot here, it's not going to be on the back of the back. It's going to be really low towards the sacrum here. So the flyer has to wait until the base places their foot on her sacrum there. As soon as she feels that, she's going to kick her legs one at a time. And watch her stag. It's very important. See how she stags her leg? This stag here controls a lot of the weight that's going back and forth. Notice how I met her in the middle. I'm bending my knee to make her kick over easier. Once she's kicked over, then I can kick up. My foot is right there, like underneath her sacrum bones, right basically right on her butt there. This would be a little too high, I think, on the lower back. So right basically on her butt or a little bit underneath her sacrum bones. It's different for every flyer, but generally speaking, I think that's the best spot, right there on the butt. What's happening here is she grabbed the top of my foot. Sometimes flyers will grab that way, and I feel like it looks prettier if you grab the top there. It just draws a nicer line. Notice again the top stag. If she brings that stag really close to her body, it brings all the weight over this way. So it's important for her to undo that stag a little bit to where the weight of her leg pulls her away, creating this nice counterbalance. As she drops that leg a little bit, it pulls the weight away this way, and she's forcing this counterbalance to happen. She's pulling on the leg. I'm taking my right foot, I'm pushing it that way, and this left leg, I'm just balancing it straight. So I'm trying to keep her balanced like that. So it's a nice V. Most of the action here is just for support, and my right leg is actively pulling her that way. And again, she controls a lot of the distribution of weight with that stag, so you can communicate to each other how much of that stag she needs. And to add for one little more flair, you can create lines with your arms here. Maybe something like that. And that is your backfly side bird counterbalance. It's a bird now, just tracking the feet lightly and come on out. So be super mindful for her to not stag too deep, because she does throw on the flyer's weight, they'll come back too far this way. Other than that, let me know if this is helpful. If there's anything that's confusing, put it in the comments and I'll try to answer them. Until next time, have fun and be safe.